later on the day here. Decided to come down to Deer Creek Park, Maplewood, and fix this place up. There's a little bridge that goes over from Maplewood into Webster Groves to another park that he just recently did. Right down there, I noticed they put in a bicycle repair station for bicyclists, which is pretty cool. I've never seen one of those before around here. And then we got a baseball field. And over there, they got a volleyball. That's set up with white sand. Right about there. And we got a rocket slide over there. It's huge. Different kinds of slides that come off of it. You gotta climb the ladders and the stairs. Snow cone stand. Concession stand. Lots of little paths. Let's go over this. This is the same creek. No, this is Deer Creek, that's right. The one I was at earlier was the Black Creek, which connects.
Yeah.
Connects it. This creek, which is Deer Creek, which goes out to a repair, which turns into Mississippi River. So, see, it's a little bit deeper. It's a lot bigger, deeper creek. Lots of native artifacts found here, lots of fossils. But I know there's other ones for no reason. And they know that this one's an encyclopedia. This creek here for being able to find fossils. Native artifacts. It seems like to me, since I used to come down here a lot before, it's a lot wider. I think it's because of the erosion. I know some areas that need to be checked. On the side there, that's going to collapse. We need to put some rock down here. We're going to have some problems in that park later. You know, putting rock down the side of holes. That's odd. Looks like a... Is that a roof? A metal roof? That wasn't there last time I was here. Once it came down that strong wind we had, it was almost like a tornado a couple of weeks ago. It came through the United States. Strong winds knocked out all the power everywhere. Midwest into the east. Let's see. That's pretty deep, man. Deer Creek's got a lot of water in it right now. In it, late at night, early in the mornings, you can see deer around here, even though we're in a suburban area, even that creek I was at earlier. You'll see a large amount of deer. I guess they've been traveling through these creeks. That's why I'm noticing these trails, game trails, not necessarily humans, just deer doing it. Preventing soil erosion at Deer Creek. Well, I got a spot we need to go check on the other side. Because that's eroding. Now we're in Webster Groves. They fix this area up. There's a hill there. That would be a good hill for when it snows. It's like the one over by Kellogg Park. Planted all kinds of ornamental grass. This is all stopping the erosion. I guess somebody noticed that the creek was getting wider, it was starting to erode. We got a softball field. Looks like they might have put these stones in, helps stop some of that erosion. Natural stones from around here. thought there was another area that I walked it down a path last time I was here, but that was an early spring. It wasn't as much growth. It's gotta be on the other side of this path here somewhere. Here it is. And I know there's spiritual beings around here. I've seen them. And the other creek I showed you. But they're all around this area. You might even see one if you look close enough. I'm going off the path here a little bit. This little open area. There's Deer Creek. I think it might be a pawpaw tree, I'm not sure. It sure does look like it. I haven't seen them in a while. I used to know where they were marching, and that's exactly what they look like. I used to know a couple of places to find pawpaw fruit. That was a different park called Castlewood Park. There's pawpaw trees all been down that was propagated by the Native Americans years ago. They're still growing in the same general areas. They've been growing for hundreds of years. Seeds in those things are huge, about the size of a bigger than a half dollar, I guess. And they'd be lined up. Tastes like a cross between a banana and a strawberry. And it gets that older, it gets the stronger the smell gets. It gets real sweet. You can almost make a perfume out of it. Going that way. Path going that way. Let's go this way. Let's keep going the main path. An area where I sat last time I came down here. There's a lot of spots up there sitting. Look at them. There's a cliff. A natural rocky cliff right there. And some timbers on the ground. You can use for like sitting areas like that. Looked over from the tree fall. It's a spot for fairies to hide and spiritual beings and Sasquatches. Because they can come in at any time they want to. They don't have to be in the middle of the woods or the middle of nowhere. People don't realize that. They can be anywhere they want to be. You gotta tell them they can't? I don't think so. Alright, what else we got going on here? 10 minutes of my video. Wondering what I was gonna do, but I wanted to show you the rest of this park. It's recently built. not very old. It was just a wooded area that was neglected and they made it into a park. I'm just dropping a snow cone and my phone. I'm trying to need an extra pair of hands. If I say that too much, I might grow on you right now. These days. Bench donated by Kids Who Care Camp. Anybody feels generous, then they want to go to their website. Donate something for Kids Who Care Camp. And this is where I'm going to sit and drink and eat my cherry snow cone. Let's see if I can find